Nice washer, Kat.
Thanks. Who knew that with just a little piece of paper and a little creative know-how, you can turn this washer into a cool necklace or all sorts of kinds of jewelry?
Let us show you how we did it. We chose this image right here. This was just a piece of scrapbooking paper, but we went to the local copier and we laser printed it. That's very important. You don't want to use any type of inkjet printing on it. It's got to be laser. We just want to put our washer on top of our paper and trace the image right in the center here. So with a craft knife and a self-healing mat here, I'm just going to cut out the center first, very carefully. Okay, let's pop that center out. Next, I'm just gonna use a pair of scissors and cut around the edge here. Just do some nice, small, detailed cutting here. There we go. There's our little donut-shaped piece of paper. Grab our washer. You wanna put the smoother side down and place your paper on top of the rougher edge. That way, the smoother side will hit against the skin and it won't give any irritation. I'm using an all-purpose adhesive here, and I'm just going to apply it liberally, making sure I have glue on every little inch of this washer. Let's just apply the paper onto the washer. Give it a little press down, and make sure all my edges aren't popping up. There we go, on there perfectly. I'm gonna set this aside for 24 hours to dry. So I have one here that's already been drying for 24 hours, and we're ready to add our diamond glaze. Diamond glaze is a glass-like finish, and it gives it this beautiful raised finish like this. So the way to apply this is, I'm just gonna put a stream of it around the whole middle part of our washer. And then I'm using this wood skewer, and I'm just gonna spread it out. Just working my way around. I'm just checking to make sure that the diamond glaze is over the whole entire surface, and it is. So you want to set this aside for 48 hours. Just make sure it's on a flat surface and you don't touch it, and you get something like this. There it is.
And now I'm ready to string this up into a necklace. I'm going to cut my cording into a 21-inch piece. You could make it longer or shorter depending upon how long you want the necklace to be. And I'm just gonna simply fold it in half and thread it right through the center of the washer and feed that right up and just do a little loopy-loopy. I wanna take a bead and just feed it right through both of those cordings. To do the clasp, it's very simple. And all you wanna do is take one of the ends and fold it over about a quarter of an inch. Just gonna place that folded edge right into the bed of the end tip, and I'm using some flat nosed pliers and fold in one side. Just give it a good push and then fold the other side over. You can use leather cording or something that's kind of gross. It's called rat tail.
Wow.
That's what it's called, rat tail. But it's that real shiny kind of satiny cording. And now I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. So simple, all you need now is a clasp. I've just got the traditional little necklace clasp here, and it's got one part that has the spring closure and two jump rings. So on one side, I'm gonna attach one jump ring just by taking my round nose pliers and opening up that jump ring, stick it right on in to the hole on the end tip, close her up, and then I'm going to open up my second jump ring, put that clasp right on there and attach the other end tip and give it a close. And you are all ready to go.
Can I put it on you?
Let's see, Steve. Oh no, it looks terrible
we'll
on
care.
You.
Come on. Let's get serious here. All right, let's see.
What do you think? Too much?
Let me see. Ready?
Too gaudy?
Let's see how it looks. I think it, well, maybe this can go away and change it out to the pink one.
I hope that this has inspired you to take a second look at the hardware store. You never know what kind of jewelry you might find there.